This video is for people deciding between no clean and water soluble solder paste technologies, or who are considering cleaning a no clean. It will tell you the benefits of no clean formulations and the value of proper reflow profiling. Ed, we have water soluble, we have no clean technologies. What are some of the misconceptions with regard to activity levels?
A lot of people still feel that the water-soluble chemistries are the way to go and the reflow profile, but we found that as the solder paste deposits have gotten smaller and smaller, that actually the oxidation resistance that a no-clean will give you, their rosin-containing, provides a better reflow results at the end of the road. And the reason for that is that the water-soluble chemistry is very active indeed, yes. We have suppliers pack a ton of activator in them. We know that we're going to clean them. But the oxidation resistance that a rosin provides is you can't find that in a water-soluble chemistry. Rosins are not typically soluble in the solvents that are used in those systems. So the no-clean, the rosin that's in them, does a much better job at oxidation resistance, especially for the smaller paste deposits.
Very interesting. What about other misconceptions regarding no-clean?
People see the word no-clean.
Right.
And they assume that you can't clean it. I still get that question or that remark from our customers, and it's simply not true. We give our chemistries, our no-clean chemistry specifically, to a number of cleaning companies like Kaizen and Zestron, and use their expertise in cleaning those chemistries. Now, there is the term, you know, like dissolves like, so it's very important that you use the proper chemistry to clean that no-clean, but they are very cleanable.
So cleaning a no-clean, sounds almost like an oxymoron.
Yes.
What's a good example of where we would clean a no-clean?
Customers that will clean a no-clean are generally those that are going to do conformal coating afterwards, so that the conformal coating will adhere to the board assembly much better. Some residues, a little sticky, soft, tacky, you may get poor adhesion of that conformal coating.
Okay, another major misconception that persists in the industry is that one profile does all, or one recipe does all.
Yes.
That profile, the resulting profile, is going to work for regardless of my board.
One size fits all.
You got it.
I hear that all the time. Now, if I take a cupcake, for instance, and a cake tin, and I try to push those through the same heating excursion or the same profile, my cupcake's going to burn, right? Cake may be done, or vice versa. So it's very important that they do the reflow profiling. That's one of the first things that I ask for, actually, if somebody has an issue with their profiling or the solderability. That's the first thing I ask for is a reflow profile. As a tech guy, I mean, I have to have that data in front of me.
And where can we go for more information?
You can go to our website, indium.com, or you can send an email to askus@indium.com.
Great. Ed, thank you so much.